Hello, and welcome to your background video for the Rates of Chemical Reactions lab. I'm Ethan, and I'll be stepping in for Mitzi this week. This lab is an introduction into kinetics, which describes how fast a reaction occurs, and with a little more study, we can describe the mechanism of the reaction. The rate at which a reaction occurs can be calculated using its rate law expression. For the general reaction, A plus B yields C. The rate law expression has the general form, rate equals K times the concentration of A raised to the X power times the concentration of B raised to the Y power. The chemist calls these powers the order. The reaction that we will be performing today has a balanced equation that shows iodate plus 3 sulfurous acid yields iodide, 3 sulfate, and 6 hydronium ions. The important thing to know is that the balanced equation is related to our rate equation, but doesn't define our rate equation. The orders don't come from this balanced equation. We have to run our experiment. The general rate equation is rate equals K times the concentration of iodate raised to the X power times bisulfide raised to the Y power times hydronium raised to the Z power. We need to find out the values for all of the powers as well as the constant K. To get these values, we need to be a little clever because there are 4 different variables. It would be difficult to model an experiment to find the values of all 4 variables simultaneously. So to make it simpler for ourselves, we are going to decrease the concentration of the bisulfide and the hydronium to the point where as the reaction proceeds, their concentrations do not change in a significant way in relation to the iodate. Then we can change our K constant to include both of these terms. We'll call this K observed now to reflect this change. Now our rate law looks like this. Rate equals K obs times the concentration of iodate raised to the X. That's a little easier to manage. When you collect your rate data, you will time a series of reactions in which you vary the concentration of the iodate. When you first mix the reactants, the solution will be clear and colorless. And eventually, it will undergo a color change. This color change, unlike many reactions that we perform, actually signifies the end of the reaction. The color change is only able to happen once the first reaction here has run to completion. Then the iodine is able to react with the starch solution to produce the dramatic color change. If we go back to the rate law that we have, we can manipulate this into an equation that reflects the graph of our data by taking the natural log of both sides of the equation, which gives us this. The natural log of the rate equals x times the natural log of the concentration of iodate plus the natural log of k obs. This will mean that the slope of the graph that you will make will be equal to the x that is here in the rate law. That should be enough to get you started. Please go watch the technique video now.